has fallen when fear is coming. Still, you're calling me when faith is lost and my hope exhausted. You will be my strength when my mind says I'm not.
Antioch kids.
How are you this morning?
Did you tell me? Did you tell me how you're doing? I'm doing good. Thank you for asking. Hey,
it's time for worship, and I'm so excited because I brought Liam back this week because Liam is going to help remember and remind us of a song we used to sing a long time ago. And then I taught Liam our new song from last week. So we have two new songs you probably haven't heard in a while, unless you listened last week and you remember. So let's get super stretched out and ready because today is a fun and crazy worship day. Are you guys ready for this? Let's stretch it out, stretch it to the left and to the right, get those arms moving, get those legs moving. Let's get ready to worship.
Waking up, knowing there's a reason. All my dreams come alive. Life is for living with you. I've made my decision. You lift me up, fill my eyes with wonder. For every young in your love, this freedom's untainted. With you, no moment is wasted. Nothing like living.
was, am I living it? What? Do I live in it? Yeah. So astounding. Love is an ocean, you can drown me. The sweet embrace, the lovely taste, I taste the sea. I'm under grace, the place to be. It means I'll never need an umbrella. I'm cool in the cold, in the hot weather. Whether or never I ever understand, I'm a man in the hands of great plans. I stand with faith and a life I never known to touch. And still I saw my clutch, but I'm like, what's the dream of? What's the hope in? What's to die for? Live to no end, this is living. The life I've been given is a gift. If I'm a living, I'm a living to death. So what's the dream of? What's the hope in? What's to die for? And live to no end, this is living. The life I've been given is a gift. If I'm a living, I'm a living to death. Yeah.
I love dancing with you guys. I love that we get some new songs. This is so much fun. All right, it's story time. Go ahead and take a deep breath after all that dancing. Take a seat. Can anybody remind me who we talked about last week in the storybook? Does anybody remember? If you were sitting at home and you said Samson, you would be right. So this week, we're gonna talk about a woman named Ruth. No pictures on the first page, so I'm just gonna read it to you guys. Are you ready? It says, "The faith of a foreign woman. Over time, a great famine came to the land of Israel. Naomi, her husband, and their two sons moved to the land of Moab. There, the boys grew up and married two women from the foreign land. Everyone was happy. But years passed, and Naomi's husband and sons died. Now the women were alone. Naomi told her sons' wives she was going to return to Bethlehem. Ruth ran down the road after Naomi. 'Wait,' Ruth called. 'Wait for me.' Naomi stopped and turned to see her daughter-in-law racing to catch up with her. The older woman put down her belongings and shook her head. 'No, Ruth, you must stay here. Moab is your home. Your parents live here. It would be best for you to be with them. But I will be sad if you leave without me. Wherever you go, I will go too.' There on the road, Ruth made her choice. She and Naomi had been through so much together. It was time to start a new life. 'You are truly a daughter to me,' said Naomi. 'We will go together.' When the two women arrived in Bethlehem, all the townspeople welcomed them. They remembered Naomi. They were happy to have her back in their neighborhood. When they learned about Ruth's kindness to Naomi, the people were pleased to be her friend too." So look, there's Ruth calling after Naomi on the road. All right, let's see what happens next. Ruth and Naomi were made a home in Bethlehem. Even though they were poor, they thanked God for providing for them. Each day, Ruth tried to find food for herself and Naomi. Her mother-in-law suggested she go into the fields owned by a rich man named Boaz. "He is my relative, so he will take care of us." Every day, Ruth went to the fields of Boaz. As the harvesters finished cutting the stalks of grain, Ruth followed them to gather what was left behind. One day, Boaz noticed Ruth. Boaz was a generous man. He told his workers to let Ruth gather as much grain as she wanted. He shared his lunch with her and sent home extra food for Naomi. Soon, Boaz and Ruth fell in love. Naomi was grateful to God that Ruth had found a good man to marry. After a while, Ruth and Boaz had a baby boy named Obed. Ruth and Naomi's sadness had turned to joy. So there's Ruth picking in Boaz's field, and then there's Ruth and Boaz and little baby Obed. Such a good story. Guess what? Ruth actually has her own book in the Bible. It is in the Old Testament. So if you want to read Ruth's story all by yourself this week, you can find her in the Old Testament. I love you so much. Have a fantastic week.